Hey guys, hi and welcome. In today's episode, we're going to take apart this Canon 24105 f4 image stabilization. This is the first version, and what I'm going to do, I'm going to split this teardown in two parts. The first part will focus on the most components before reaching the barrel. The barrel requires a second part just to explain a bit more what we can do over there. The down thing with lenses, especially zoom lenses, is that they require calibration once they are disassembled. So we'll talk about also what options do we have. We might have some options, but definitely the best thing to do is the final calibration once the lens is repaired. Pretty much that's it. I hope you enjoy this video. If you like it, just put a thumbs up. If you have anything to say about, anything to add, just use the comment section below. And yeah, let's go with the teardown. Okay, so the first step we're gonna need to take off will be the mount ring. In order to take the mount ring off, we need to take these two little screws hidden on the side of the ring. Basically, this will release the mount, the connector mount that connects with the camera. Two tiny screws. You might need a 00 Phillips screwdriver. Also, a screwdriver that you can use a screwdriver for the one used for repairing phones. And also, we need to take this cover off. So it's enough to use your thumb, put it inside and lift it. It might be a bit harder than looks in the video, because this is not the first time that this lens is disassembled. So there's some glue on the cover. So you need to release this the contactor, the mount, the connector. And next, we're gonna need to take off these four screws. There are four screws. Okay, so now that we took all the screws out and we release everything, the reason the mount is stuck is just because of the rubber in between. It's better if you put the prime tool the place I'm putting now, not the way I put it before, because you risk to damage the ceiling, the rubber ceiling. The rubber ceiling is for keeping protecting against dust, nothing else. Dust and humidity. Don't think that this will protect against water. It might do something, but definitely is not a sealing for water. Next step, you don't need to sign anything on this step because there are the two points, the aligning points. So next step is this cover. Is the rear, they call it a rear assembly barrel. Next, we're gonna prepare to disassemble the motherboard and we need to disconnect all the ribbon cables. On this flat cable, I'm using a different tool, a different set of tweezers. But I will disconnect the other ones first. You must be very careful when you disconnect these connectors. Are very fragile and very easy to damage. It took me quite a while at the beginning to be able not to damage them. Probably this is not the right tool, but now because I know how much pressure I need to make, it's quite easy and safe for me. Also, The set of tweezers I'm using are not the best one to use here. If you don't have any experience, I'd recommend to use another. You're gonna see later what kind of tweezers I have, the type of tweezers I have, and definitely I recommend to use that ones instead of using these ones. These are too sharp, and there's a risk of damage. So these are the tweezers I have. So I'll be bigger. And also I put a shrinking tube, a very tiny shrinking tube on the very ends in order to avoid any damage. So that helps quite a lot. There's a tiny screw here, the only screw that holds this the motherboard. Also, in this case, there's no need to sign the position of the motherboard. There's only one way to put it. The screw on the motherboard has to match with the hole on the plastic. This is the motherboard. The motherboard almost never fails. The most common problem might be humidity or water. Next is by taking off the zoom ring. It's kind of a group here. But before we continue with the video, I wanted to point out something. So what I'm going to do next, I'm going to take the key, the zoom key off. Later on, I'm going to take the zoom ring off, which the zoom ring, and there's another group that comes off altogether. Very important, if you need to take the replace parts here, it's okay to do it this way. But if you don't, you can skip this step. And also, there's another important point. if you're about to take the reach the zoom ring, do some repair on the zoom ring, keep in mind that you have to take off the brush contacting contactor brush before doing any further step from now on. I don't know if that it's clear enough, but you're gonna understand a bit better further on. So as I said, there are different ways to manage this next step. And if you're about to do repairs on the zoom ring, you need to take that contactor brush before touching anything from this step further. So even if you need to replace, I don't know, the zoom key, which is this step that I'm doing now, first you have to take this contactor brush off before doing any further steps. Okay, so you must be very careful here. This is the zoom key. It's quite impossible. It is very difficult to bend that zoom key since it's very short. Probably the lens has to get a very major impact in order to bend that zoom key in some way. There are some other lenses that the zoom key is longer than the one we disassembled from this lens. But yes, this probably is not the case to replace the zoom key. Okay, so what we are doing next, we are taking off, we are preparing to take off the zoom ring. It's the group. And in order to take this screw off, you need to clean the glue that's on the head. There's some glue on the head. And if you don't take that glue off, you're gonna damage this ribbon cable. So you must be very careful here. The other three screws are easier to take them out. There's nothing in between. You might find some glue also on these screws when you take them off for the first time. Okay, so now very gently, you just pull off this group. You must be very careful when you're gonna put everything back. Try to remember the position. There's only one way to put this back. There's no necessarily need to sign the position. If you think you need to sign up, just put some signs on the sides somewhere. Okay, so next step, we're gonna disassemble this group. We have the zoom ring, and we have the switches for the out of focus and the out of focus, manual focus, and the zoom and the stabilization on and off. But before we do anything, we need to take off the contactor brush, which we should have done this before taking the zoom key off from this tutorial. Try to not move too much this zoom ring, otherwise you're gonna damage this contactor brush. So again, very gently, I'm trying to disconnect this tape. And also, in order not to damage it, and use the same, and not put another another tape. Okay, so next we need to take this screw off. Try to remember the position. The best thing is to put a sign, to sign here. But if you need to replace it, you need to put it in the right position. And you have to do this while this component is mounted off the lens in order to find the end point, like 24 millimeters. Go to 24 millimeters and you can put this contactor brush in the right place. It's quite hard to me sometimes to explain things, but I do hope you get most of it from these videos. Okay, so now we can, if you need to replace this zoom ring, we need to pull it. There's a proper position. There's a specific position that you have to put it. It's from this point. We have to go back until we reach this end here, and then we can slide it out. Like so. So if you need to replace the zoom ring, this is the way to do it. Be careful, there's lots of grease over here. If you want to replace that ribbon cable, the one on this point, it's quite impossible. You can replace it, but you cannot take it off and put it on another camera. You need a new replacement. Okay, so next step. I am taking off the selector for the switches for the auto focus, manual focus, and stabilization on and off. It's quite tricky. After this screw, there's a double tape that holds it in place. I do recommend to use a hairdryer or heat gun in order to create a bit of softness of the double tape. And also, you have to be, there's another, the ribbon cable has, is, there's a point when it's stuck in place. So before pulling this out completely, we need to release the ribbon cable. Also, I do recommend to use some heat at this point, just to warm up a bit the double tape and be able to take it off easier. Otherwise, since it has this bending point here, it's easy to damage the ribbon cable. Okay, so now we can pull off the selectors, this switches, buttons. So if you have problems with the selector, if the buttons doesn't do anything, this might be the reason. Doesn't happen that often to these buttons to fail, but yeah, it might be the case. As I was saying before, this is quite impossible to take. Well, you can take it off, but you cannot put it back. So once you put this off, this disconnect this this ribbon, whatever is this contactors, I don't know how to call it, you're gonna need to put a new one. There's no other way to do it, because this will deform and will create bumping points, and it will be impossible. Also, this barrel, on this point, I was trying to explain earlier, at this point is where the mount ring gets hold it in place, and holds the entire lens. Okay, next. Finally, we managed to skip that step. Next, we gonna take off the USM ultrasonic motor. So if you need to replace the motor, this is the right way to do it. You need to follow all the other steps, unless the components that goes off from the zoom ring, you can take off the whole group and leave it as it is, and just go continuing the disassembly of the motor. So as you can see, I'm holding this the screwdriver in this position just to have a bit of a control of the screwdriver, and in order to avoid not damaging the screws. Is they are quite hard at this point. These screws are quite hard to take them off. As you can see, there's also some glue on the heads. If you don't have the right screwdriver, you're gonna damage these screws, and you might struggle after to be able to undo these screws. As you can see, this comes straight forward. There's no nothing in between. The motor comes with the focusing ring, and we can separate the two parts. So there's no necessarily need to take the whole group if you need only the motor, or also if you need only the focusing ring. There are four screws down here, so we're gonna take these screws out in order to release the two components. There's another screw hidden inside here. Quite hard to say it, and quite hard to take it off. Okay, we have the last screw. I'm holding the both components with my hand in order not to drop the motor, otherwise it will fall off. So to align the two components, it's enough to follow the printing names when you want to put them back. There's also a flat cable that holds in place. And very carefully, it's not in a great place, but it's quite easy to remove it. Here we have two gyroscopic sensors for the image stabilization. Next, I'm going to take this rubber off just to show you how to, in case you need to replace the manual focus ring, and how to reach the collars that you have to pull them out, take them out. So you need to take these collars out. There are four of them. And by doing so, you're gonna be able to replace the manual focus ring. And also, if you have damaged collars, you can replace them by doing so. This is the basically just to count them, second, third, and fourth. So there are four collars. Okay, so next, we're gonna take off the front lens element. Probably many of you were curious how to reach this point. Definitely, you don't need, if you're about to replace the front lens element, you don't need to disassemble your lens. You need just to pull off this cover. And next, there are 2, 4, 6, 8 screws, I believe. So also this sign here need to match with this sign here. There's no need to sign anything at this point. You must be very careful, otherwise you're gonna damage it. You're gonna create some marks on this cover. The best way is to use some heat, not too long, just enough to soften it a bit. A couple of seconds. So we have the screws. I've said 8 screws, but there are 6. There are 3 sides, 2 per side. And also keep in mind that once you touch this lens, the whole lens needs calibration. If you're about to open up this front lens element just to clean up your lens, to clean it for dust, you need to sign a point between the lens and the filter mount thread, and in that way you're gonna put the lens in the same position. All these screws are the same. The screws, they have a glue lock. If you want to lock them back in place, I suggest to use a nail polish. Okay, so at this point, we release by taking this last screw, we we released the lens. I am using a suction cup. Also, you can do it by hand. I'm just doing this for, it's because I have it and it's safer not to leave any kind of dirt, oil, dust. So this is it. If you need to replace your lens or if you need to clean it, the first lens element, this is the way to do it. Keep in mind this filter, this spongy mesh. Okay, so next step, we're gonna separate these two parts. So if you have a damage on your filter thread, this is the way, this is the component that you need to replace. This is called barrel filter. There are three screws, all the same. There might be a lock. By the way, this is the point for matching this element. When you if you need to pull it out and replace it, there's no need to sign anything. It will match it with that point. This is it. Nothing fancy, but yes, now we know how to replace it. Okay, next, and this will be the second last step before we're gonna finish this this teardown. And on the other teardown, the second part of this this teardown of this lens, we're gonna disassemble the barrel and all the components that are inside. So there are three screws here. Keep in mind that once you're gonna reassemble the lens and you're gonna put the screws back, you're gonna need to put some something to hold them in place. If you don't have a proper glue, I recommend to use the nail polish. Just a tiny amount of nail polish on the heads should be enough to hold them in place. Okay, so now we are taking out this zoom barrel assembly. If you have problems with this, now you know how to do it. It's quite rare that this fails, but yeah, this is part of our teardown. Okay, so next, this is the last step. This is the proper way to replace the autofocus, the focus lens element. As you can see, there are two signs here. If they are missing, you have to put them in order that to know when you're gonna put your lens back to put it in the right position. This is the last component that we took out from this first part of this tutorial. Next, we're gonna focus on the barrel and all the components that are inside. Definitely requires calibration, and also there are some tweaks that we can do to avoid that. Not 100% accurate as a calibration, but still there's something we can do over there. Also, the second part of this tutorial, of this teardown, will cover the most common problem with this lens, which is the aperture flex cable tends to break, and because of that the lens fails to communicate the aperture fails to work and there's a repair is required. With this, I do hope you liked it. If there is anything that you want to add, if you have any questions, and if you're still here, consider to subscribe, put a thumbs up. Thanks for watching, and see you in the next one.